Welcome to the stage, director Wong Chun, Eric Tsang, and screenwriter Florence Chan. Let me start with Eric Tsang. I want to ask you about your involvement with this film. You've been known in the past to support young directors, Adam Wong before, Derek Kwok. So I want to ask you how you came across the project and what interested you in it.
之前我識黃俊導演，我仲合作部短片，咁喺個短片嗰度，我已經覺得哇，呢個導演好出色啊，係亦都諗唔到佢拍咗一個咁嘅題材。嗰陣時我入去揀想拍乜嘢，佢揀咗一個竟然間係一對老人家，原來個男士一路陪住個太太到戲完先知道原來個太太死咗好耐。
I was actually first got to know Wong Chun because there was a short film in which I was involved, and actually it was interesting. The script is actually about a couple, old couple, and then they spent a lot of time together, and then somehow at the end, I then realized that actually the woman had been dead for a long time.
所以我當時我就好欣賞呢個導演，我就同佢講話，不如我哋一齊合作拍部長片啦。咁跟住佢話，我已經寫過劇本寫咗兩三年噶啦，而且有個角色好啱你做嘅咁。And
then after seeing this short film and knowing the director, I said, well, you know, maybe we should do a feature film together. And then Wong Chun said, actually, I have a script. It's been ready for 2-3 years, and in there is a character that's perfect for you. So I said, what is the story about? I'm very excited. He told me the story or the synopsis of the story, and I heard about it and I said, ugh, I really hate these types of films, to play in these types of films. I remember in the 1980s, I had watched a film similarly heavy in its message, in the story. And I remember that I was with a whole group of friends. We had said, you know, after the film, we all go for karaoke and dinner and all that. After that film, I went home and slept.
So I said, I won't make these films because I want to bring joy to the audience. I won't make these that make the audience unhappy. So when he said that, I said, I won't make them. But I promised him, I so much like him, I won't even ask him to bring the script to see.
So basically, you know, for things like that, I just didn't want to be involved in films like that because I wanted people to be laughing and happy and then I'll go home. But then since I did speak with Wong Chun and asked him about the story, I thought, well, at least out of courtesy, I had to ask for the script. So I asked for a script to read. But then you see that script and you see this film, of course, it's irresistible. It's a film that actually has a spirit that is in some way encouraging despite the nature of the story, and yet it's written by a young lady and also directed by a young gentleman. So I became involved in this film.
Thank you. So thank you very much. So I want to ask you about the nature of this film. It's multi-layered. On the one hand, it's a portrayal of mental illness. It's very much a film about Hong Kong as well, with its hyper-competitive sort of atmosphere. So what came first in there? I mean, it sounds like the original idea was really quite different from the final film you made. So I want to ask you about the early stages of the film up to Eric Tsang's involvement.
I think it's better to let the screenwriter talk about the... Yeah.
你講英文，我就唔使翻譯嘅最好。其實係，唔好啦，我講我豬你翻譯啊，因為 其實一開始同而家又冇咩好唔同嘅，一開始係由一篇新聞開始嘅。
Actually, the place, the actual script, the script actually is not very different from the first draft to actually what you see. It actually started, and the first gem of it, or the germ of it, was actually from a news report.
咁嗰個新聞就係講一個好相似嘅，就係講一個中年男子去照顧佢爸爸嘅時候，咁有啲衝突，咁個爸爸就意外過身，咁呢個中年男子就被控誤殺。
It's something that is also very Hong Kong, this specific news. And this news story is very simple. A middle-aged man was taking care of his father, who clearly was incapacitated. And then somehow, because of an accident, the father died. And this man was actually, you know, charged with manslaughter, but he actually got out.
那篇新聞又講到其實記者去問嗰啲鄰居，咁個鄰居就話其實呢個男人係好好人，好友善，好孝順嘅。Yeah, basically,
the report also included the reporters interviewing the neighbors, and the neighbors said that, you know, this actually was a very caring son, somebody who was a very nice person.
咁所以就令我會諗點解其實會發生個咁嘅悲劇。So
the question is that how did this tragedy come about? What triggered it?
同埋咁之後，到底呢個男人佢要點生活？And
then also now, with the father being dead, how does this middle-aged man continue his life?
咁所以就開始咗寫呢個故仔。So
that's actually how this whole idea started, and also that was what actually was the germ idea for this script.
咁跟住我哋做咗好多訪談啊，好多資料搜集啦，因為呢個題目。
On this topic, we actually did a lot of research. We interviewed a lot of people.
咁其實我諗 Florence 開咗呢個題目啦，亦都開始寫呢個故仔嘅時候，我哋都開始慢慢發現，有啲嘢可能我哋未係咁了解得咁多，或者我哋越寫越知道，我哋要了解多啲乜嘢方向嘅嘢。
Basically, when Florence started planning or thinking about the script, we actually had to delve into many things that we didn't know and then we actually had to do more research and more research.
咁啊，最後其實我哋聽咗好多故仔，好多真嘅人真嘅經歷，而其實最後大家啱睇完呢個戲啦，入邊好多嘅對白，好多嘅情節其實都係真。We
collected a lot of stories because we talked to a lot of people, and I just want you to know that in this film, what you saw, the dialogue, things that happened, small events and so on, a lot of them really did happen in real life.
所以有時可能有啲 critics 或者有啲觀眾會覺得啊，好似呢個戲有好大嘅野心，擺咗好多議題落去。其實調轉我哋覺得係啊，我哋經歷咗即係呢個創作嘅中途，其實我哋發現原來一個咁嘅 character 要生活喺香港，佢自己就會面對好多問題。
Some critics actually saw this film and said, wow, what an ambitious project, you know, incorporating so many different levels of stories. But you know, if you think about it, really, if you live in Hong Kong, you are in that type of a situation, that type of a person, these are the various barriers that you actually have to face.
所以我們做的功夫反而不是想加什麼下去，我們在想 其實我哋做唔到咁多嘢，因為我哋發掘到嘅問題實在太多。我哋諗緊點樣能夠精簡啲去講。Actually,
we didn't have to expand our story in many way, because of so many things that we had collected in our research. It's a matter of how to actually select and actually trim it down.
咁啊，最後就成咗呢一個版本。And
this is the version you just saw.
A very quick question before I turn to the audience. I'm sure that a lot of you have questions, so I'm just going to give you one more question. I thought the title itself was interesting. We chatted a bit earlier, and I thought it had an interesting story. You call it, it's called Mad World, but the Chinese title is quite different. So can you talk a little bit about both titles?
當初 Florence 起了第一個題目叫做 Mad World 啦，咁就英文名先。
It started actually with the English title, Mad World.
咁啊，Mad World 即係大家好 straightforward 啦。Mad World 就係啊個世界好瘋狂。So
it's about a world that has gone mad.
咁啊，後來一路再發展落去，我哋需要一個中文嘅片名。咁啊，諗咗好耐都諗唔到。咁啊 ，Florence 就機緣巧合就遇到，即係都一個緣分啦。遇到一年無名呢四個字。
basically, we had to find a Chinese title for this film, and through perhaps you can say destiny, somehow Florence actually came across these four words, Yatni Moming, which actually is from Buddhist scripture.
我覺得是很巧妙的,即是你說Mad World就好像是說世界很瘋狂,即是好像你和外在環境是分開了。But
Mad World, if you talk about the actual English title, it's about how you relate to the world outside you, because it's as if it's you against that whole Mad World that is outside.
但是我自己個人,很多時候都會更加覺得中文名更加有意味,更加深遠一些,就是一念無名,其實說你 一時之間看不透,你不夠智慧去看清楚事實是什麼?
But the thing is, I prefer the Chinese title, and I'll explain a little bit. Yat Ni Mo Ming is actually about, you know, the idea of somehow at a certain moment in life, you actually didn't see things clearly. So it's about that moment of not being able to see or being blind.
所以其實英文名提及那個Mad World,很多時候其實是我們製造給對方的。 我們因為看不清楚,我們應該珍惜什麼,或者做什麼行動,最後我們給了對方很多sufferings.
So basically, mad world is the idea of what we create for other people, because it's that madness, or that anger, and anything that we cause is what we cause to them.
因為你就是我的世界,我就是你的世界,我們一起生活。 因為你就是我的世界,我就是你的世界,其實我們是
It's as if it's me against you in the sense of your world versus my world. But the thing is, you have to remember, we are all in it together.
所以兩個名字加在一起,就覺得echo得很完妙。
So, mad world has its meaning in English, and then 一念無明 has a different shade of meaning. And actually, this contrast of putting the two together is actually what makes this actually kind of makes us all think.
Bipolar, almost.
No, it's not bipolar.
All right, voice of wisdom. Your turn, guys. If you have questions, please raise your hand and speak loudly. It's sometimes hard to hear from here.
有問題可以舉手，可以用廣東話。
There's a gentleman.
哇，好厚啊，那個。好厚啊，好厚啊，最後那個。
Okay.
Very good.
That's quite a question.
誰答啊？
這是一個很好的問題
Thank you, it's a great question
我們花了很多心機去做那個 subtitle 因為裡面有很多都挺巧妙的廣東話的一些用法
Yeah, remember that Cantonese idioms are great And it's, you know, we took a lot of time to work on English subtitles that can capture something
先不要說你講的那些例子,只是說仆街
Oh my god
我們已經想了很久。Okay,
thank you. Actually, there's a very famous Cantonese idiom that a lot of people know, which is what he just said, which I will not repeat, which actually basically means asshole.
Asshole. 仆街是很特別的廣東話來的,因為它不是只說你壞還是什麼。 我哋後來反覆思考咗好耐，點解簡直都唔啱？原來仆街咧有少少佢辜負咗你嘅意思，你同佢係有關係有bonding嘅，但係佢辜負咗你對佢期望。
But there is so much, you know, finesse in that term. Actually, it has to do with not just, you know, simply just recalling, you know, calling somebody by the name, you know, by asshole, because it has to do with somebody actually is somehow doing something in relation to you and somehow having broken a promise. Or somehow reneged on something, and therefore you suffer.
So, when a friend tells you you're a fool, the feeling of resentment or the feeling of disappointment is very, very strong.
So, can you imagine when a family member, such as a mother, saying that to a son? So, you could imagine that level of just many, many, many meanings and the depth of that meaning.
咁啊，仲有其他好多例子就係，誒，我哋發覺。 折墮啦，係啊，折墮都係好難。咁啊，我講埋落去。I
don't know how to translate.
How to translate 折墮
？I'm thinking，
諗緊。折墮。冇理由。OK，
你開始講折墮先。咁啊，係真係有好多好
specific， 或者可能廣東話係好懶嘅，所以咧講一啲好簡單嘅字，但係其實背後有一大堆嘅 supporting 嘅。Yeah，OK，I
have it，I have it。 Jito is the idea that basically even the world and the earth and everybody is actually punishing you because you have done something so bad So very 唔啱啦 I don't think so. Yeah, they're looking at me.
節度是什麼 like 你嗰個版本係都係 fair 噶嘛？
啊，
節度就有啲好似唔 fair 嘅，即係冇理由嘅。
Okay, yeah, the thing is yeah, 節度 is that it's not as if that you have done something wrong. It's that the world is so unfair that somehow for whatever reason you were completely out of luck and you were completely down. Bad karma.Oh yes,
yeah,
thank
yeah,
you.
但係又爭少少喎。
But no, not quite. He said, not quite bad karma.
因為咧，折墮咧又有少少犯賤咁樣嘅感覺。
折墮 also still has to do with something that you have done wrong at some point, and also you have done it wrong.
Yeah, so 係啦，就係咁啦。咁廣東話就係咁樣。咁我哋花咗好多時間去做翻譯嘅 Florence 啦，誒 screenwriter 啦，啊 Felix。Felix,
Florence.
作為發行公司嘅同事啦，我哋做咗好多功夫去諗好多方法，想唔好成堆字喺個畫面度，但係你都明我哋講緊咩。
Yeah, the thing is to really be able to translate. If you do a literal translation, that's your title would be so long and nobody would be able to understand. So we really had to spend a lot of time to be able to create subtitles that are so condensed that you would get it.
咁所以確實係，如果你係睇英文版本咧，係有少少係流失咗嘅，有啲意思。咁可能當然佢亦都會成為另一個版本咧，佢有佢自己嘅圓滿嘅方法。咁但係你問我啦，當然我會 prefer 大家學廣東話睇廣東話。
Yes, very simple. I mean, if you just read the English subtitles, there is something missing because, after all, Cantonese is its own idiom. You know, if I were, you know, in the ideal world, I want all of you to learn Cantonese and be fluent.
Thank you.
Great answer.
Come on, 教會呢個先都係好多時候我哋放映完之後會討論嘅其中一個環節。咁啊，其實教會呢個先咧係一個身邊一個真嘅事情嚟。
People have discussed after seeing this film regarding the church scene. And just want you to know that actually it is based on something that happened in real life.
咁當然啦，嗰啲細節唔係一樣啦。
Perhaps details are adjusted。
咁但係係一個都好相同嘅情況，就係、是、一個好親嘅人帶你去一個教會嘅分享嗰度。咁但係喺對方冇準備之下咧，你想去好坦白咁樣去修補呢個關係，反而傷害咗佢。
Basically, the situation is exactly like in this film. You know, somebody who's very, very close to you takes you to such a type of gathering, and then without actually, you know.Any sort of telling you in advance, suddenly you are completely put in the spot because that other person is on stage trying, seemingly, to actually somehow to, you know, apologize or ask for forgiveness. But actually, the result was exactly the opposite.
咁啊 ，Florence 同我聽咗呢件事之後，我哋第一個反應唔係話覺得信仰有問題，或者唔係覺得教會有問題。問題喺邊個度？問題喺人嗰度。
When we heard about the story, I mean, what we...thought was not actually, you know, whether it is the problem of the church or any or religion. It's actually on the people.
甚至都唔係佢心腸嘅問題定咩，而係有陣時我哋好想幫對方，我哋好想做好嘅事，但係我哋永遠都做咗個錯嘅方向。
In the idea that sometimes when you know in relationships when people actually are trying to do something to help the other person, but actually when you don't understand, your actions turn out to be totally harmful.Or the result is completely opposite.
咁我覺得呢個先雖然咧好似忽然間有一個關於教會嘅先，但係其實我覺得呢個先係同呢個戲入邊所有嘅關係其實都係一樣連結得好好，就係、是、關於其實入邊咁多個關係，父子又好，母子又好，情侶又好，甚至其他人都好，其實佢哋冇一個我覺得係一個特別嘅壞人嚟嘅，佢哋只係用咗一啲錯嘅方法去相處。
So the idea of the church scene is really about relationships. And the thing is, in this film, you could see there were all these relationships, father-son, mother-son, also between lovers. I just felt that it is about the relationships and how sometimes with the wrong action or despite people having the good intentions and not actually being bad themselves, you actually ended up with the wrong results.
所以其實嗰個可能係 Jenny， 嗰個可能係大海，嗰個可能係阿東，甚至嗰個可能係我哋， 我哋有陣時以為自己幫緊對方，或者以為我哋好愛對方，但其實我哋做緊啲嘢，可能其實傷害緊對方。
Sometimes, you know, in any of these characters in the film, or even us, when we think that we are actually showing something or helping somebody that we love, but our actions and what we've done is actually exactly the opposite.
咁所以點解即係瞭解或者溝通係咁重要？咁啊，另外你講到超市咁樣。咁啊，呢個都係一個我覺得超市嗰個先係一個非常之神來之筆嘅一個先。咁當然要問 Florence 啊，寫到教會之後，我問佢咁跟住點啊？我唔知點喎。
我食朱古力。
係啊，跟住 Florence 就同我講話。
我唔知點解。
係啦，我寫到教會之後，我就話：哎死啦！咁跟住點寫落去都已經搞到一塌糊塗咯嗰件事。咁我就問佢跟住點。咁因為 Florence 有一個好非常之好嘅天賦嘅才能，就係佢永遠都能夠知道角色會做啲咩。佢就話佢會去揾一個有朱古力嘅地方。
So basically, so we were developing the script, working on the script, and you see that after the church scene, and then he walks out. What would he do? So I asked Florence, what would he do? What would our character do now? He's totally in a bind. The whole situation is pretty messy. And then Florence said, eat chocolate. Because Florence has this amazing gut, you know, understanding, gut feeling to say, you know, to know what that character would do, and that's eat chocolate.
咁啊，咁但係 eat chocolate 之後會發生咩事？其實我哋都唔係特別想安放啲咩去批評啲咩，其實係一個我覺得好自然喺香港會發生嘅事。
But the thing is, the idea of the cell phones and all that in Hong Kong, this is something that is now very, very natural.
咁啊，
世界都係啊。
往後嘅都係好自然會發生嘅事咁。
So things really follow as if one after another naturally. There's a something that follows.
我哋其實呢個劇本係寫嘅時候係一早已經係叫做 tailor-made 想曾生去做。
This script when we were developing it.In our minds, in our ideals, it was for Mr. Eric Tsang to play the father.
咁好彩佢冇拒絕到啦，如果唔係我哋就都唔即係唔知點樣。
Fortunately, he actually accepted the role, or else we wouldn't know what to do.
咁然後啦，佢應承咗去做爸爸角色之後，我哋就諗，咁佢個仔會係邊個咧？即係一個配搭嚟噶嘛。
Basically, we need somebody who could be a partner who would match. And so when Eric Tsang agreed to be the father, we said, oh.Who are we going to find as the son who would match him?
咁除咗佢自己嘅仔之外咧，我覺得冇人係比葉文樂更加適合。
And we think that apart from Eric Tsang's real biological son, the one who is closest would be Shawn Yue.
因為其實我覺得佢哋係兩個有一個好相同嘅一個氣質，亦都係好香港啦，亦都佢哋嘅年齡或者佢哋本身又好熟啦。其實佢哋好快令到大家可以信服佢哋一對父子。
I mean, they have rapport. They also know each other very well, and also they get along very well. There's a lot of these two characters when they work together that you could feel very comfortable. You actually believe that they are father and son.
咁好彩，葉文樂都係應承咗去做啦。
And Shawn Yue also agreed to play the son.
咁啊，呢個係一個，我覺得係一個即係個好夢寐以求嘅配搭，亦都係因為兩位好非常之願意去幫忙喺一個咁細嘅製作入邊去演出。
They are the dream team, and also both of them have such great heart to want to help us. And so in that way, it really it's made that film possible.
Thank you. Next question.
This is about the cultural difference, especially specific scenes, how different cultures react. And this one was the going back to see the psychiatrist. Was it a comic scene?
其實都唔單止呢個 scene 嘅，我哋都有時都幾 surprise 喺某啲我哋覺得唔應該笑嘅 scene 咧，喺香港都咁夠有人笑嘅。
Actually, I can tell you that even in Hong Kong audiences, when they see certain scenes that we didn't expect people to laugh, and they were laughing.
所以可能未必係關 culture 性，未必係關文化嘅事。
Maybe it's not about culture。
不過啊，譬如我都覺得醫生個先咧，其實有啲人笑係一種苦笑嚟嘅。
Actually, I think that you know, in that seeing the psychiatrist, that scene, you know, you can hear people laugh, but it's more like a bitter laugh。
咁啊，其實即係當然啦，你依然都仲有好強烈嘅幽默感嘅話，你可以當係一個黑色幽默咁樣去閱讀啦。
If you were very very humorous and you feel that you know you have the sense of humor, then you can consider that black humor.
咁啊，但係關於其實一個好諷刺或者好無力嘅 situation 就係、是，需要幫助嘅人去到揾到公即係公立醫療嘅服務啦，佢都得唔到即係真係好適當嘅協助。但係其實調轉個醫生其實佢都唔想嘅。佢作為一個醫生，佢唔想咁樣對佢病人，但佢得到嘅資源同埋時間都係好少。
The thing is, it maybe is some sort of a sarcastic type of commentary on public health.That you know, the doctors didn't have the time, the patients, I mean, there's just not enough resources to take care of people with mental health problems.
Thank you very much. I wish we could continue all night long, but unfortunately, we have to wrap up here. I think Eric's quite tired too. So thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.